Hey guys, welcome back to Ozakwe TV, and today we're going to be making snail and guang guang. As y'all can see, right off the bat, I'm gonna let y'all know, you know, I was born in America, so I might not have the Nigerian accent, but you know I'm trying. So what we're gonna start with first is washing my hands, you know, why not? Get all the nasty stuff out. And what we're gonna do after this is we're going to wash the snail with salt. Because I already got the sliminess off with alum. So yeah, wash my hands. I already got all the sliminess. If y'all know what alum is, y'all just Google it. I already got all the sliminess off everything. So now, I'm just gonna wash it with salt now. Oh yeah, as y'all can see, I have this and this. I have a bigger plate, so like I can really, because I have big hands, so I can really get my hand in and like clean it up with the salt. So yeah, all you're gonna do is put this, look at this plate, as y'all can see. That's it. Get some salt. Get about like this much of salt. Maybe even a little bit more. Just spread it on there. Maybe even a little bit more, just a little. And then all you're gonna wanna do is just grind it. Grind it first. Just rub it in. And then you're gonna wanna add some water. Cold water. As y'all can see, it's not turning gray because, like I said before, I've already cleaned it up. So it's not going gray or anything. It's kind of, if you think about it, this is kind of like cleaning it like Aquarel. It's just really, it's the same concept. You're just grinding it and getting, just mixing, you know, grinding it. That's what I'm trying to say. But yeah. Alright y'all, I've been grinding it hard enough. I think it's about ready to be done without the salt. So all I'm simply gonna do is pour off the water. Place it back onto the plate. It's all good, we're washing it anyways. It can fall off. Grab that, put it in. I drop. That's why it's a good thing to always clean this. Grab what I drop and then simply wash off the salt and all that stuff that I put in here or water. And redo this whole process. So you're doing the same thing without the salt. So, basically, like as you can see here, you're basically redoing what I did just without the salt this time. But I've done this like 6 or 7 times, you know, with the other stuff off camera, so it's good. I know it's good by now. It's good. So, now that I'm done washing it, let me get out the water once again. Like I always do, add the onions inside the pot. You know what I'm saying? I always do that. Add the onion inside the pot. And don't put no salt on this. Add the onion. And then move it a bit. You know, I always do that. I just put onion, we always do that. We put onion inside the pot for texture. this in. All I'm gonna do, wash my hand, you know. And then what am I gonna do now? Simply stir it and put it on the stove. Like I always do this. You also start like, you know, start memorizing and start understanding. If you really like keep up with our videos or watch and actually really try to learn, y'all are gonna start to like realize it's the same process over and over. You know? Like for the porridge, it's gonna be like the same things. For soups, it's gonna be same things. Look at that. I'm just moving it a bit. I'm just moving it, getting it in. For porridge, same things. For soup, same things, you know? We're not all soups, but some soups, same things. The different type of fufu soups and drinkable soups. But yeah, it's just start getting repetitive inside your mind now. Now I gotta mix it in. All we're simply gonna do is move this pot to the stove. So come on, let's get over to the stove, guys. And then all we're simply gonna do, like always, is boil it. Oh, silly me. I forgot to add the water, y'all. Come on, guys, come on. Coming back, guys. Don't forget to add the water like me, guys. All right, guys, we're going back now. Come on. Road trip. Now that we're back, we're going to get to adding the water. What you want to do is you want to add the water to the same level. You want to add it the same level as the snail. I don't know how I forgot the water, but it just don't do that. All right. Now all we're gonna do now is let it boil, and I get back to y'all when it boils. What's up, y'all? So as y'all can see over there, the snail is boiling as of now. And while the snail is boiling, I'm gonna go ahead and blend what we need. Sadly today, no crawfish, just pepper and onion. So let's go ahead and get that in. All right. So now, all I'm simply gonna do is blend it. This type of a blender, you gotta make sure it's tight or it will come up. All right, but yeah, just plugged in and it hit left. Hey guys, now what we're going to do is we're going to add what we blended and some red oil. So let's get to that. Boiling. No. Let me add the red oil first, why not? Red oil in. Now, all we're gonna add is our blended products. That's in too. Now, all we're gonna do is simply move it around and mix. Down, left, right, up, down, left, right. It's gonna mix it in, I promise you. There we go, as y'all can see, it's starting to mix in. Starting to mix mix in. That should be good. Let me mix it a little bit more. This is good enough now. And what am I gonna do? Simply leave it to boil like I always do. Cap it or close it. I'm gonna let it boil. But yeah, I'm gonna keep stirring and keep adding the leaves, and I'll get to y'all when I'm adding the last bit of it. I say when I'm adding the last one, you know what, whatever. Let me just put it all in at once. Let me just get it all in. Ain't no cutting. All one take. Get that little bit in. And we gonna stir this like a pro. So this is how you make snail and guanguan. I hope y'all enjoyed the video. And if y'all did, make sure to leave a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe. And I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye, guys.